Thank you for attending another NetCloud Security video. Today I'm going to be talking about how to use Truecrypt on Ubuntu Linux. First you'll want to do is you'll want to go to truecrypt.org, go to Downloads, choose the version you're using. I use 64, so I choose that, click Download and save it. I've already done that. So I have it in this directory right here. To run it, sudo space dot forward slash truecrypt, enter my password, and there it goes. When I install it, I accept it, and then it's done. To uninstall, type that, say okay. Press enter to exit. Done. Now, I launch it. And what I have here is I have a Truecrypt. Now, I don't have anything to use on it, so I have to create a volume. Create one. And I'm going to create an encrypted file container. I'm going to do a standard. I don't really want to do a hidden. Hidden basically gives you the ability to create two, and then you type in your password, and it looks like it loads, but it only loads part of it, and the rest of it's hidden. So I'm going to select a file. Since there isn't one, I'm going to make it. I'm going to call it encrypted container.tc. I'm just calling it that because it's Truecrypt. You can call it whatever you want. You can call it that. Actually, I'll call it .text. So it looks like a .text, but it's really not. And I'll save it there. And then, I don't want to ever save my history. Click Next. And you can figure out what you want to use. I always use AES Two-Fish Serpent. And I use SHA-512. Hit Next. And I'm going to make a very small one. I'm just going to make a 10 megabit. One, hit Next. Now, password, you want to make something strong. I'm just going to type password. You do not want to use password, I'm just using it for this demo. And I want to use a key file. So, for keys, I'm going to use tempfile.txt. And what temp file is just this. You can use a picture, which is what I recommend, but I just want to show you how this works, so I'm going to use this little file right here. Click Open. And then OK. Then Next. Password's easy to crack, says 20 characters. I want to continue yes, because I'm not worried about the security on this. This is just an example. And what do I want to do? Let's do FAT, because that way I can access it from a Windows machine, too. Next. And now what you want to do is you want to move the mouse around as much as possible. And the longer you go, the stronger the cryptographic strength is. And I'm going to stop here, just because I don't want to spend time on this. I'm going to hit Format. It's done. So it's created. I'm going to hit Exit. Now you can see encryptedcontainer.txt. If I try and open it with, say, LeafPad, that's what you see. It's encrypted. There's actually nothing in it right now. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to select a file, select that, click Open, and then I'm going to choose Mount, Passwords, Password. I'm going to use a key file. And I'm going to use the tempfile.txt. Say OK. Say OK. And it will ask you for your administrative password. So I'm going to say OK on that. And it should load. Now, what I'm going to do in here is I'm going to create a document. I'm going to call it file.txt. And then I'm going to edit it with LeafPad, I like Kate, but LeafPad opens quicker, and this is a single file, and it's nothing big. So, this is my file. I have nothing to hide. This or protect. This is for demonstration purposes. Alright, I'm going to save it. Close it. Now, if I open it up, let's cancel that. Let's open it up with LeafPad again. You can see it's in there. Great. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to dismount. And it's gone. So it's within there. I'm going to open it again with LeafPad. And you can see, you can't see what's in there. It's encrypted. So close it. So that's how you do it. And when you're mounted, you just drop and drag whatever file you want. Now, it's important to note, if you mount it, I'm going to type password, and I'm not using the key file this time. I hit OK. Incorrect password or not a TrueCrypt volume. So you do need the key file. So I'm going to go down here. You see how there's three dots in the end here? I'm going to put it down to one. I'm going to save it. Then I'm going to choose my key file. I hit OK. OK. Incorrect. Alright, so I'm going to put another dot back in. I'm going to save it. Hit OK. And it comes up. And now I can access my file again. So, the important thing to note here is that the key file, if one bit is changed on it, it no longer will access it. So, one thing you can do is you can take a picture and basically tack on, if you want to enter a PIN or you want to tack on anything at the end of it, if you want to merge files, you can do that. Basically, so you need to have that exact file. Now, it's important to note that if you do it this way, which is the most secure way, then you can send a file to somebody, give them their password, and get them the key in a different way. And unless you have the key, the file, and the password, you can't access it. And if you lose that key, you're done. There's nothing you can do. If you lose the password, you're done. There's nothing you can do. It's a very secure method for saving files. If you have tax forms you want to save in there, if you have maybe applications you've had for jobs that have sensitive information, if you have address books that you want to protect, if someone actually gets on your system, if they don't know what key you're using, and only grab the file, and do even happen to find the password, there's nothing they can do. So I hope you found this useful, and I thank you for joining another NetCladSecurity video.